Connecting to a Productivity Series controller via Ethernet is easy. You just plug in via USB or Ethernet. It doesn't matter which. Go to CPU, choose CPU. The Productivity Suite software scans the entire network and shows all the compatible Productivity Series hardware that's available to you. Looks like I have a bunch of them on this network. Now I've plugged in both the Ethernet cable and the USB cable, and sure enough, I see both of them are here. This is the same Productivity 2000 controller, I just have two options on how I want to connect to it. If you choose to connect via Ethernet, which we're going to do here, then you'll need to change the IP address to be compatible with your PC's network. Otherwise, the Productivity Suite software won't be able to find it when we try to connect. You can see that if I hit the connect button. It's telling us this IP address is not compatible with our network and we need to fix it. Well, we know that, so let's do it. Click on Change CPU IP Address and type in an IP address that is compatible with the network. The Productivity Suite software verifies that it won't collide with other devices on the network, which is awesome, by the way. And just like that, we're connected and we can start programming our application. Easy. Now what if we change our mind and decide we want to use the USB connection? Well, just go offline on the current connection, and then it's the same thing. CPU, choose CPU, and this time select the USB connection. The beauty of the USB connection is you can program the controller independent of the IP address. And since you aren't using the Ethernet port to connect, you can set the controller's IP address to be compatible with whatever network this controller will ultimately end up in. To change the IP address so it is compatible with that network, make sure you're offline and go to CPU, choose CPU, highlight this controller, and change the CPU address. And just like before, the Productivity Suite software validates that IP address and you're ready to go. The USB connection is also great for when you're out on a remote location and you don't want to change your laptop's IP address to be compatible with that installation's network. You can just plug in via USB, select the controller, and go. Exactly what we did a minute ago. And while I was using a Productivity 2000 in this demo, you would do the exact same thing for any of the Productivity Series controllers. If you have any questions, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. And don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.